Greetings, Belfont, and welcome to the second day of the Red and White News Broadcast for 2023. I'm your host, Dominic Kemper.
And I'm Olivia Abrey. We have quite a few fun and interesting segments by students for students. Our segments will be featuring a rock studio preview, information on Chalk the Walk, a few dad jokes, and a variety of other videos.
And with that, let's jump right in. Have you met Mr. Stock? He's one of Mrs. Lloyd's student teachers. This next segment takes a closer look at his choice of fits.
One take, one better.
Alright. Shoes. Dick Sporting Goods. Socks. Dick Sporting Goods. Pants. Sam's Club. Shirt. Target. Belt. My dad. Lanyard. Heinz Field. Chain. Grease. Alright. Nike Cortez. Nike.com, I think I stole it from my roommate. My socks, pants, Gap, belt, Men's Warehouse, sweatshirt, Pittsburgh Bowling Association, lanyard, Aggieshire Stadium, collared shirt, I don't know, Target.
Go further this way. Okay, ready?
Go. Nike Blazers, socks, jeans, pants, Dickies, shirt, Target, belt, Men's Warehouse, vest, Prada, scarf, Hogwarts, bag, coach, and lanyard, Steelers. And the flower, Lloyd's Closet, and the chain, Grease.
Thank you, Mr. Stock. We appreciate your participation and your outfits. Last week, students were able to purchase a sidewalk square to help earn money for Minicon. We have more information on the Student Council Initiative. Let's take a look.
Hi, my name is Christine Morris, and I'm the advisor for National Honor Society and student council here at Belfont Area High School. 2 years ago, we did an inaugural Chalk the Walk event to raise money for pediatric cancer through our mini-thon efforts for the Four Diamonds Fund. And Chalk the Walk is basically where people will sign up to get a sidewalk out front where they can design a chalk drawing. The money that is coming up, the money that comes in basically for all pediatric cancer therapy and treatment. And it looks good that we're interacting with the community and we're reaching out to help those who may need some more help. But this year it's going to be on May 4th and May 5th as the rain date here at Belfont Area High School.
Looking forward to seeing these sidewalk creations. Next up, we have some corny dad jokes.
What kind of car does an egg drive?
A car 10.
A yolks wagon. Alright, we're good. How do you follow Will Smith in the snow?
I don't know how.
You follow the Fresh Prince.
Oh, how's it going?
Alright.
Hello, Mrs. Morris. What kind of music did the Pilgrims like?
I don't know. What kind of music did they like?
Plymouth Rock.
Okay.
What kind of things does a farmer talk about when they are milking cows?
Beats me.
I don't know.
Utter nonsense.
Okay, what do you call two monkeys that share an Amazon account?
I don't know what.
Prime mates. Yeah, got a second joke for you.
Okay.
What's green, has red hair, and sits under a rainbow?
A leprechaun.
Aaron R. Miller.
you're gonna do laps for that.
Haha, those kids, hilarious. Vaping has been an issue, and the following statement is a PSA on the dangers of vaping.
Some common effects of vaping include addiction, shortness of breath, headaches, feeling irritable, restless, and unable to concentrate, cardiovascular disease, lung damage, respiratory illnesses, anxiety, depression, affects dopamine levels, essentially killing your joy and stealing your happiness, may lead to use of other drugs, and is known to cause cancer.
Here you go.
So if a student gets caught with a vape device or any kind of nicotine product at school, our handbook states that give the kids a couple days of in-school suspension as a consequence. Because it's against the law, we normally file a criminal complaint with a magistrate. First-time offenders can do sort of an awareness program for nicotine and avoid it being sent to the magistrate the first time. But if a student doesn't complete that program, or if they have more than one offense, we file a complaint with the magistrate and students can end up being fined for it.
Thank you for that information. Please do not vape. It is not a good habit. As we near the end of our broadcast, we have two more fun and lighthearted segments to check out. Our first one is a bathroom experiment.
So my name is Mr. Rabarchak. I teach music classes and band. So marching band, jazz band, concert band, film music two, music technology, rock studio, class piano, music theory. First time that I taught rock studio was spring 2020. And it's right before the shutdown happened. So we had for, 5 weeks. And it was just at that point there were 5 students in the class and now we have 15 in the class. So it was just a very different feel going from that semester to this semester. Rock Studio was offered, I want to say Mr. Zimmerman started it maybe 10 years ago. And it's a course that kind of have some of our arts courses on a rotation of every, being offered every other year. And the way it worked out was, this is the year it was offered, last time was spring 2020 that I had taught it. But at one point, they'd have multiple sections of this class after it was first started. But Mr. Zimmerman was the one to come up with curriculum and ideas and kind of pass things down and kind of take in what he has come up with.
I am Alan. Grade 12. I play, as most of you probably know, guitar. But in the last one, I also played trombone. And in this upcoming one, I will be featuring a soprano saxophone. I really like doing, I mean, just anything blues, because the genre is just kind of a improvisational field, and I can kind of just play and see where it goes and develop my musicality.
I'm Seibel, I'm a senior and I play guitar. I really like playing Black Dog by Led Zeppelin. It's fun to play. So there's kind of like an echo there. It can make it sound really weird.
Hey guys!
I don't know what you want from me.
Ian Yachik, grade 11, and I play bass, sometimes guitar, sometimes drum, and sing. Favorite song to play? Probably Only in Dreams by Weezer. I like Journey and REO Speedwagon. I think I Wish You Were There is a good one. Take It on the Run's pretty good as well.
My name is Jack Nedro, I'm a senior. I play keys and drum set. I enjoyed playing Tourette's at the last concert, and I'm looking forward to playing Venusian 1 and this concert. King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard.
Hi, my name's Madigan Ash. I'm a senior and I play saxophone and synth and bass for Rock Studio. Well, we're playing Carry On Wayward Son by Kansas. I'm looking forward to that one. We're also doing a Pat Benatar song. If you want to be in Rock Studio, pick up an instrument, learn some chords, learn some notes, be confident. Be confident. That's my one biggest piece of advice. You definitely get to move away from classical tunes and marches and things like that and actually play fun stuff like blues and jazz and rock. Yeah, you get to hang out.
I love that it gives students a chance to learn music in a way that they might not be familiar with. So we have some students who are from, they're in concert band, they're in marching band, they're in jazz band, they're used to reading music. This gives them a chance to learn music just by listening to it, following a chord sheet, and kind of learning things using their ear only, not reading music. And it's also, I love the collaborative, like, hey, let's keep an open mind. This is not going to be the version of the song that you might know from the recording. Let's keep an open mind and collaborate on what we want this to be. So coming sometime in quarter four, we're going to be having another live performance during Raider period, probably similar to what it was a few months ago with the 9th and 10th grade one day, 11th and 12th grade another day. Looking forward to it. Had a really great response last time. Looking forward to having you all out there again.
All right.
I'm looking forward to that performance. And that's all we have, folks. Thank you for watching the Red and White Broadcast.
Have a great rest of your day, everyone. Tune in again next time.